So are you more of an indica or sativa guy?
Yeah, no.
You know, I feel like I could really talk to you. I feel like you really listen.
But yeah, no, I'm not familiar with
I feel like he really gets me. I am with Damon at Meadowlark 64 in Denver, Colorado. Hi, Damon. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks. Hey, I wonder if you can talk to us today about vaporizers. There are so many. What do they do? Everyone has so many questions. Mm-hmm. I don't know where to begin. So can you help me out?
Absolutely. Okay. One of the first things I always try to determine when a customer comes in looking for a vaporizer is what they may have used in the past. Also, what they plan their intended use for, because you have the ability to vaporize dry herb, waxes, and oils. My desktop units here are pretty nice. The Silver Surfer by 7th Floor LLC out of Colorado Springs is what I would think is a premier dry herb vaporizer. And the herbalizer here is actually a unit that was developed by former NASA engineers that can both do dry herb as well as your waxy concentrates. And it's just a very premium unit. You're going to have a portability factor with the pen style versus a more stationary approach with your desktop units. A lot of these vaporizers here will accept one form or another of the dry herb, wax, or oil. I do have two units here that actually accept all three, and you can interchange the atomizers to accept all three.
This, you said, is a three-in-one, correct?
Mm-hmm. Correct.
Can you kind of show us how this works? Show us and show our friends here at home, because we want to know.
Absolutely. We'll go with waxy concentrates because the atomizer is already in there. You simply just have to take a little dab of either your wax or your shatter, scrape it onto the ceramic heating element there, simply then just pop on your mouthpiece here, and then it's just as simple as just depressing the button and inhaling. The other option, twist off this little screen here, put a little ground up dry herb into this, put this back onto your pen itself, and then you throw the sheath, your mouthpiece, right over that. And now you have the ability to vaporize dry herb.
So it's like a one-hitter, kind of.
Yeah, for the most part. I mean, if you're going to be sitting at home and you just want to take a couple puffs at the end of the day, it's going to be perfect for you.
Okay.
The third feature to this iPuff pen is going to be your oil chamber, like hash oil or something to that effect. E-juice for nicotine can also work well in here, too. Filling it up just so it doesn't exceed the top of the atomizer here. Throwing the cap back on with a little rubber grommet that's basically going to hold the oil in place. And now you've got something that you can take out with you. You put it in your purse, can put it in your pocket. You have it all night. The charge on this particular battery is probably going to last you from about an hour to an hour and a half with continuous use. So that's the three-in-one.
I would call that the triple threat.
Indeed. It can be if you try to use it all at one time. So
I would never do that, nor would anyone else, right?
Right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching Green Light. We'll see you next time on FourCornersTV.com.